This is the plaintiff, Stephen DeChabert. He says he loaned his friend his car, and 2 days later, the guy brings it back all busted up. He broke the heater on it, cracked the gear shift off, and now the thing won't even start. The defendant owes him every penny of the $2,000 he had to put into the car to get it working again. And that's why he's here suing. This is the defendant, William Mabry. He says he used to be friends with the plaintiff until the guy tried to pin the blame of his broken down car onto him and is trying to get him to pay to fix it. The plaintiff even told him the car had problems when he lent it to him. Even if he had $1 million, he wouldn't give the plaintiff a dime because he's a dirty, lying rat who should be ashamed of himself for suing him today. He's accused of breaking down a friendship.
All parties, please raise your right hands.
Welcome back to the People's Court. Next case in the docket, the plaintiff loaned the defendant his car and says 2 days later it was a mess. A cracked gear shift, busted bad bumper, that's for starters. But the defendant says the car was a wreck when he got it. It's the case of stop busting my rear.
Thank you, Douglas. Okay. Stephen DeChabert, you are suing your former friend William Mabry for $2,000 in damages that you say you sustained as a result of him damaging your car. Let me hear what he did.
William had a problem with his car, which was with the stickers. The stickers that go on the glass, your registration sticker, and all of that. So he didn't want to keep his car on the street. I even had asked the man, why don't you put it in the parking lot? Oh, I ain't got no money for that. So the friend as I am, as with most all my friends, I try to help him. So I did help him. I told him that you could put your car in my parking spot, and then you can hold my car until you get your money up as next month to get your sticker.
Okay. When you say hold my car, meaning he could borrow your car?
Yes.
Okay. And what car was that?
It's a Mark 7 Continental.
What year?
1988. It's classic.
88?
Yes.
Wow.
Beautiful car.
Do you have a picture of it?
Yes.
Can I see it?
Turns right over.
So while we're waiting for that, so you allow him to borrow the car, and what happens?
Okay, I loaned him the car, and then I explained to him that I have to go to the doctor. So he came back the next day, picked me up, because he took the car that night. Let's just say like
so it comes back the next day, he picks you up, he drives you to the doctor?
Right, let's say like Monday it was when he took the
car. How long did he have the car?
A day and a half.
Okay. At some point after that day and a half, once he's returned the car to the parking space, or to where did he return the car to?
Back to the parking space. So he bought the
car. So he leaves your car in the spot and he takes his car?
Yes. He said, oh, your the heat is acting funny in your car, so
I'm just taking my car.
I'm gonna take my car.
So then you go to your car and what do you find?
The car ain't moving right.
How? Describe what is wrong, because I can't picture it.
It's stuttering.
Stand up, please. Tell me what's going on here.
What's going on is this. What happened was, we went downstairs to the car. We tried to move out, because he was going to drop me off home. But it wouldn't move.
Okay.
So Mr. DeChabert said, Mr. Mabry, what you going to do? What you did to the car? So he said, you got to handle this, man. So he gave Mr. Mabry back the keys. And the following day, Mr. Mabry brought somebody else over with him. And that evening, but Mr. Mabry dropped the keys off after he brought this person over to see the car. But when we went downstairs, the gear shift was laying on the side then.
Do you have a picture of that?
You got pictures right
there.
Let me see. The gear shift was laying on the side?
On the side. Laying, like, you know, it's supposed to be like this in park. It's laying like this on the side.
What happened, Mr. Mabry? What happened?
When we were out together, me and Mr. Ball here, we were out in the car. We were coming down. We stopped in the gas station. We got some gas to put in it. And I told him that the heat went out on the car, and I couldn't pump the brakes. The brakes wouldn't go. So I called. I let him know that then. So I finally got the car running in the gas station where the heat came back on.
Okay, I really don't care about the heat. What happened to the gear shift of this car? Look how it's bent to the side like that.
Well, this is what happened. I took it out another day. After the car was there, it was a cold day. It was really cold, and we couldn't get the get it to crank at first. So it finally cranked. So as I pull in the gear shift back to try to put it in drive or neutral or something, the cable snapped.
When was that? When you still were borrowing the car or after you had returned it to him?
After I returned the car.
And why were you in there that day?
Because he wanted me to go to get someone to see if they could, the car could be fixed.
Because already the night before we knew that it wouldn't change gears?
The transmission froze with a gear stick.
So who is it that bent that thing like that? You?
Okay, we're going to do it again. Best friend wants to borrow your car. Would you loan it to him?
Yeah. Why? I mean, if it's your best friend, you would pretty much assume he's going to bring it back.
What do you think is going to happen if he gets in a car accident?
Oh, man.
Oh, man. Didn't think of that, did you?
No, I didn't.
Okay, what do you think?
I would, but, man, as long as he's got some good insurance and everything, yeah.
Guess what the problem is here? I'm just going to tell you real quick. What if you have a lot more money than him and he gets in an accident and the person says, I don't care about him, I'm going after you?
There's going to be a situation then.
Yeah, there's a situation. Going inside the courtroom.
Well, I had got it out of gear one time, and I was trying to get it back because I wanted to turn the car around the other way. And it collapsed on me.
Wow, you must have applied some pressure to that thing to get it to bend like that. Weren't you surprised when it bent in your hand? I mean, that thing has lived for how many years? 25 years it's been around. It's withstood the test of... I don't know how many weather incidents, I don't know how many people handling it, Lord knows the action it's seen. And then you just come in, and how is it you bend that thing completely like that?
Well, it has always been done hard to manage since I've been driving the car.
Yeah.
So, you know, it could have been getting old or just up there. Yeah.
And how is the Blue Book value of this car, the amount that you know, you want $1,300 for repair, no, it's $1,600 for repair. For the car, and the car's not even, a 92 of this year wouldn't be worth that. So how is it that this car is? How are you going to prove to me that it's worth those kind of repairs on a 25-year-old car?
Because I'd be putting it in the shows. It's a show car.
Really?
Yes. If you've seen the picture on it, you can
prove
see
to
it's
me,
a nice
I just want you to
car.
Prove to me one moment right now that you've been putting it in shows.
Excuse me?
Prove to me you've been putting it in shows.
And you ain't telling me, I ain't know I'm supposed to bring that proof today.
That's fine. I mean, you're telling me it's so mint and amazing and incredible. Yes. Why do you loan it to him, your show car? How many show cars you got?
Well, just that one now.
Oh, okay. And then, so you lent your show car to him?
No, because that
one's bust up?
Okay. The parking spot.
I got you. I got you.
Yeah, I know you
All right. I know you know. You. I know you know I got you. Okay.
I know.
So, here's what's going to... Do you have any proof of the towing fee?
That's the yellow one.
Okay. You don't get emotional anguish.
I don't get that.
You do get your toe, which is 136. Mm. And I'm going to cap your damages on that car at $750 for a sum total judgment in your favor in the amount of $886. Pay the man. That's my judgment.
Let's find out from the defendant right here. What do you think of that decision?
I think it's a lot of... I don't think it was a good decision, though.
Good decision?
Not a good decision.
Why not?
No, because, I didn't break the car. It was already fabricated. It would have been breaking.
You know? If you didn't break it, somebody else would have broken it pretty soon.
No, it would have fell broke anyway.
Yeah. After a while. Well, what about you guys? This is your buddy over there. You guys are all still friends, or you and all... Both of them still friends?
Yeah, I guess we're gonna be friends, but hey, I still gotta pay them.
Yeah.
You know?
That's what happens sometimes.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, right down there, okay?
All right,
so step on in here, sir, and step here, right here, and work. What are you thinking about this outcome now? And your buddy there?
I mean, I'm showing proof of how much I had to pay for it. It wasn't really about what year the car was or any of that. She see the bill, it says what it is. You know what I mean? He broke the car. It's not like it's a fake bill or nothing.
Right,
I paid
so,
That's you all he had to do. Just pay me. That's all.
You still lend your car out to any of your friends who need some help, whatever?
Yeah, I'll be going. Yes, I will. Yes.
He needs a car tomorrow. You got your car?
It ain't fixed.
Oh, it's not fixed yet, so he can't drive it? All right, not tomorrow.
No, because I took the plates off that one.
All right. Okay.
I changed the plates.
All right. Harvey?
So when you borrow somebody's property, Kurt, it is called, legally, it's called a loan for use, which means you have to use great care, which is such a high level of care that if something gets damaged, it's going to be your fault. And that will do it for this case. Litigants for the next case on the way into the courtroom right now.